Kin Collective formed in 2011, and it consists of 8 extremely talented actors from different backgrounds and skill sets, and they've collaborated to make this powerhouse team. I like to kind of think of them as the Avengers, but of acting. They brought me on board to design the set for their debut show, Glimpse. Glimpse started from absolutely nothing, a blank canvas. And the performers devised the show through improvisation and the techniques they learned through New York acting coach Larry Moss. So the show ended up being a series of glimpses and vignettes that stitched together. We had to meet with the venue very early on because the concept we were pitching was a little bit different. Instead of building and designing a set physically, what I would do is digitally draw the set, animate it, and have it projected behind the performers as they performed. And as the scenes changed, the projections would change. Of course, if you're going to do that, you've got to be really careful that the performers don't step into the projection. So we had to do a lot of projector tests with different projectors and lenses to get the maximum keystone so that they had the maximum amount of space to perform within. And once we had that amount of space designed, I knew what size I was working with, and the lighting designer, Chris Cheney, knew exactly how to seamlessly integrate the lighting with the projection so there were no hard edges. All of the creatives sat in on the rehearsals and the development process. It was a very organic process because the soundscapes, the lighting, the set all came from the same process in tandem with the actors. So any gaps that the dialogue left, any questions that it left unanswered, could be answered through sound or the set. Once I had the basic set designs down as far as locations, I went out and sketched using real-world inspiration as far as Melbourne goes, because it is a fantastic city and a great canvas to work from. So much texture and detail and lots of different colours, and I just took out my sketchbook and sketched for about 2 weeks straight. I went out and sketched everything that would fit the scenes so that I could whittle that detail down to just what I needed and nothing else. My whole ethos behind the set was, just because you can doesn't mean you should. So any animation would have to be essential to the scene. I took all the sketches back to the studio and worked them up into a fully realized drawing, assigning colors to each of the characters. Then I took those sketches onto the digital realm and illustrated them on a Wacom Cintiq. Once I had the scenes drawn, I could animate them, not pulling focus, but really drawing the audience into the scene and having the performers interact with the background whenever they needed to, but only if they needed to. Russell Goldsmith designed an amazing soundscape for all of the show. We used QLab to stitch together the audio and the set design. And once that was all put together, along with Chris Cheney's lighting and the final script, we were ready to go.